In India right now, we have 300 million people without access to electricity.
Just because they are geographically disconnected does not mean that they should be deprived of basic energy access, basic education. You have to trek sometimes 5 to 10 days to reach these villages. The word remote does not justify how remote these communities are. They know that we have come from very far off, and they know we're here with a purpose. You really need their support. It cannot be a one-directional approach.
इसमें मैं देख रहा हूँ काफी वो भी आ रहा है तो बच्चों के लिए ठीक है ये
है नहीं तो जलाना पड़ता है
हेलो तंचू तंचू तालू सुपा ये बिजली मातों ले मातों
आप चाहते हो लाइट आए आपके पास
बाकी दुनिया में लाइट है लेकिन नहीं है
And we need technology which is small and something which can be maintained by the local community and owned by them. And that is how the concept of DC solar microgrids came in. It is easy to install, it is highly efficient, and it is a decentralized solution for energy access.
What we have done at GHE is started working on education access for these communities, where we are going out to these remote valleys and we are setting up offline internet hubs.
They have more than 60 students from the valley which come trekking 3 days to 5 days to this school here.
This is your server. This is all the information of the world stored on this. Do you want to set it up today?
Yes.
Let's go. What do you want to learn in maths? They now have access to Wikipedia, and the first thing they do, they wikied up Zanskar. That's the area we are in right now of Ladakh in India. It's really fascinating to see how kids really want to learn more about where they are, where they are living. We have technology that can bring these students on par with the students in the rest of the world. Who are these mountains to decide which child has access and which child does not have access?
It's pretty harsh, and we travel for days and days. Across mountain passes, all our panels, batteries on horses and donkeys.
And we'll be electrifying 9 households and almost we can say 60-70 LED lights and 3 street lights.
तो GHE के साथ जोड़ के अभी लद्दाख पूरा हम करने के लिए वो कर रहे हैं सर तो मेरे ख्याल में 1-2 साल में पूरा लद्दाख में जहाँ लैंड नहीं हुआ वो सब मतलब कंप्लीट हो जाएगा हमारा चैलेंज यही है जी
I became part of the Global Shapers community. I was invited to attend the annual meeting in Davos in 2016. That was truly the transformational moment. The fact that we at GHE could actually approach these leaders at Davos and were able to make an impact in communities back here speaks volumes of what the World Economic Forum really stands for.
लाइट आ गया कैसे लग रहा
है बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है और अपने काम करने को बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है खाना खाने को अच्छा लग रहा है अपने लोग लड़की लोग को ऊन कतने को अच्छा लग रहा है अपने को कोई सिलाई करने को अच्छा लग रहा है और पत्थर पुती भरने को अच्छा लग रहा है जी
It's not about providing just a light bulb, but it's about how can that light bulb really lead to economic advancement of these communities. They are not dependent on a big grid infrastructure for the electricity. They have their own resources to produce their own power. They have the resources to consume that power. And that is really the future of electricity.